A lot of people eat this fish, but very few people farm the fish. What am I talking about? Tilapia. Fish farming is a very lucrative business, but in Nigeria and Africa as a whole, one type of fish that is commonly farmed is catfish. But a lot of people want to start tilapia fish, but they don't know how to go about it. I have gotten a lot of questions about farming tilapia, so I went out to do my research, and not just the theoretical aspect of research, also the practical aspect, which is starting a tilapia fish. So after over a month of starting tilapia myself at my backyard, I'm ready to give out some lessons on how you can start tilapia fish farm, the lessons I've learned, and other things that you need to know when it comes to tilapia fish farm. If you're ready, let's dive in. Hello, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Daniel. If you are new here, I help you discover, learn, and improve your processes when it comes to agricultural business and other business opportunities. If you have not subscribed, please click on that subscribe button, turn on notification so that you don't miss anything when I release my new video. The very first thing you need to start a tilapia fish farm is you need your location. You need a place where you call a farm for tilapia. Unlike catfish farming, where just anywhere, and even your backyard, a room can be used to start a catfish farm. Tilapia own is different. If you really want to go commercial, there are specific things when it comes to choosing the location of your farm. If you have your way, the best location that you can have to farm tilapia is a riverbank area or a place very close to where natural water springs out. So when choosing the location for farming tilapia, then you need to choose a very good location where you have access to slightly natural water, or where you know that when you need to construct a pond for it, then it is somewhere where water comes out automatically. Not to say that you cannot start a tilapia fish at the back of your house. You can do that, but it's going to cost you extra, and it is going to take some extra thing out of your pocket when it comes to farming tilapia at your backyard. The second thing that you need to start a tilapia fish is your pond. Here, the type of pond they are going to farm tilapia is somehow similar to that of catfish, but there are like three that are best for farming tilapia. I'm going to do a separate video on the type of pond that you should use to farm your tilapia. But for this video, the type of pond that you should look at in farming tilapia are the cage system of pond, the earthing pond, and or if there are no options, your concrete and tarpaulin pond. I'm going to do an extensive video highlighting the advantages and disadvantages of the type of pond that is best for tilapia. Watch out for that video in this series. The next thing when it comes to starting a tilapia fish farm is to prepare your pond. So when you've decided that this is the type of pond I want to use for farming my fish, then you have to prepare your pond. If you are using the cage system or the earthing type of pond, then you don't need much of preparation when it comes to your tilapia. But when you are using either the tarpaulin or the concrete pond, you have to prepare your pond depending the time your fish will arrive. This is very important because tilapia is very delicate to farm. The next thing when it comes to farming tilapia is you need a constant water. When it comes to tilapia and water, we all know water is very essential in aquaculture. But for tilapia, if you really, really want to go commercial, and that is why I said when choosing the location of farming tilapia, it is best to choose a place where it is very close to the river or where natural water springs out regularly. Water is very, very essential when it comes to tilapia fish farming, which means you need to also, if you are going to be using the artificial water system, which is like the borehole or the well, then you need to ensure that you regulate your water to suit their body system. Normally, the water pH for tilapia farming should be around 7 to 9, which is good, And if you cannot regulate your water to that level, then you need to choose a place where it is more like a natural habitat for them. So when it comes to tilapia farming, then water is very essential. I would say even more essential to farming catfish. If you are enjoying this video, appreciate it by giving it a thumbs up so that it helps the algorithm to reach more people that wants to start tilapia fish and don't know how to do that. Before we go to the next step when it comes to farming tilapia, let me just say you can become a member of this channel by joining any of the level. You can do that by clicking on the join button beside the subscribe button if you have not subscribed. If you have subscribed, it is the blue button down below this video. So click that to become a member of this channel and let's take agriculture to the next level. While you've done that, let's move to the next step. The next thing, which is the most important thing when it comes to starting tilapia, is your fish. Now, unlike catfish, tilapia is not very common. In sourcing for your fish, it's an integral part of raising tilapia. You don't want to get your tilapia seedlings from a place where you don't know the source or from an untrusted person. Sourcing for your tilapia seedlings is more important than even the feed you give them. If you have prepared the other things and you are looking to start properly and you are looking to source for your tilapia seedlings, it is advisable to go to a very reliable person or someone that you know is very trustworthy when it comes to something like this. Talking about that, if you want to get your tilapia seedlings and you want or you want training on starting a tilapia fish, send me an email. My email is showing on the screen and also in the description box. Also, my phone number is in the description box. I'm going to get you a good tilapia seedlings that you're going to like. So your tilapia seedlings is more important to get from a good source than even the fish you give them. The next thing you need to start a tilapia fish farm is the feed. Feeding tilapia is somehow similar to that of catfish, especially when they are young. Although tilapia also like natural hard feed like vegetable, breadcrumb, or even maggots in the water. But if you are going to be using artificial feed for them, they have their own special feed made for them. At the very beginning, when they just start, like what we call the fingerlings in catfish and the juvenile, you can use the same feed you use for catfish to feed your tilapia. But it gets to a stage when they start taking bigger feed, then you need to source for the feed for tilapia. Unfortunately, tilapia feed is not as common in the market like the one for catfish. It is always on special request because it is not widely farmed like catfish. So if you are looking to get the right tilapia feed, give your fish, if you are ready to start, we can get that. Just reach out to me through my email or my phone number. It's going to be well be to you wherever you are. The feed you give your tilapia is essential as well, just like the feed. The next thing when it comes to starting a tilapia fish, this should have come first, but I'm putting it to this very end, is training. Training, training, training. You cannot do without training. Unlike catfish, where you can just start anyhow without prior training, tilapia fish is very delicate to farm. You need to be very, very careful when it comes to farming tilapia without training. This is a mistake I've gone through, and I've gone through proper training when it comes to farming tilapia. So if you really want to go commercial with tilapia fish farming, then you need to be ready to go for training and pay for training. If you are looking for training when it comes to tilapia fish farming, you can reach out to me through my email in the description box and also showing on the screen. So you cannot remove the impact of training and having a mentor in tilapia fish even more than when you're farming catfish. One equipment or instrument that is very essential if you are going to be farming tilapia at your backyard or in a very small space is an aerator. Tilapia fish needs more oxygen than catfish. So if you are going to be raising your tilapia in a tarpaulin pond, concrete pond, or plastic pond, Then, no matter the quantity of fish you get, you need an aerator for them to survive in those kind of ponds. But if you are going to be raising them in earthen pond or the cage system of pond, you don't really need that. But it is very essential. That is why I said, if you want to raise tilapia at your backyard, then you should be ready to spend more money than raising catfish. If you are thinking, oh, tilapia farming sounds so difficult for me to start, and you are looking to start a catfish farm, then I have a complete playlist on catfish farming that will get you started on the right path. You can check it out here. But if you say, oh, I'm ready to start tilapia farming, then you can reach out to me and we start the process of training you on how to start tilapia farming and join the very few that are raising tilapia in Nigeria. If you have not subscribed, please click on the subscribe button, turn on notification so that you know when I release a new video. Catch you in this video.